one to another.
Yes.
All together.
And if any man hunger, let him eat at home, that ye come not together unto condemnation, and the rest will I set in order when I come.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
muster up another amen.
Amen.
Because we really have something to say amen about today.
Amen.
Despite the fact that we have no power, we have no heat and no lights, we have no
air.
That's another kind of power. But we got that power.
That's right.
Everybody got the Holy Ghost power. Say amen.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. But despite the fact that we don't have any air, we gonna go forth, Lord's word today, on the air that we got in our lungs. On the air that He specifically gave us. Worship and praise His name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us bow our heads for prayer as we be faithful and show some thanks and gratitude for the fact that we still have a house of worship.
Amen.
All right. Father God, we just come before you right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we come before you saying thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for your goodness, your love, your mercy, and your grace.
Yes, God.
Thank you for allowing us to come out to the house of worship one more time. That we may read and meditate and study your word. That we may fall in line with your word and act according to your will.
Yes.
We ask that you will forgive us for our many sins. Wash us in the blood of the Lamb. Strip us of this fleshy man. And help us put on the spirit, man.
Oh, yes.
Help us to walk according to your word. Help us to walk according to your will.
Yes.
Help us to walk according to the way you lead us, Lord God, down that straight and narrow path that leads to eternity. Lord God, we just come this morning. We want to say we love you.
Yes.
We love you.
Yes.
And we thank you. And we give you praise, honor, and glory. And as we come before you this morning, Lord God, we just want to shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We love you. You're worthy, Lord God. You're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be lifted up. You're worthy to be magnified.
Amen.
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 put something on your heart.
All right.
Yeah.
That's right.
And he gave the moment.
Yeah. Don't tell it to me.
He gave me something here. These two things I just want to share. They're very brief. There was a church in the Philippines.
Well.
That was flooded. Mm-hmm. But they still met for worship.
Come on, man. Come on.
The entire, there's a picture right here. The entire floor.
Yeah.
Was covered in water.
Yeah.
But the church is filled.
Yeah.
With members.
Yeah.
So no more excuses.
Yeah. All right. All right.
The question is how hungry.
Yeah. Woo! Yeah.
Yeah. How hungry are you? Toss up between New Living, You have to say amen?
Amen.
Amen. John 14, 1 through 19. Talking about Jesus is the way to the Father.
Yes.
And it reads, Jesus said to his disciples, don't be worried. Mm-hmm. Have faith in God and have faith in me.
Yeah.
There are many rooms in my Father's house.
Yes.
I wouldn't tell you this unless it was true.
Yes.
I am going there to prepare a place for each of you. After I have done this, I will come back and take you with me. Mm-hmm. Then we will be together.
Yes.
You know the way to where I am going.
All right.
There is five. Thomas said, Lord, we don't even know where you are going.
Yeah.
How can we know the way?
Yeah.
I am the way.
Woo!
True. Without me, no one can go to the Father.
Yeah.
If you had really known me, you would have known the Father.
Yes.
But from now on, you don't know him. Mm-hmm. And you have seen him.
All right.
Verse 8, Philip said, Lord, show us the Father.
Mm-hmm. Well,
all Jesus replied, Philip, I have been with you for a long time.
I know.
Don't you know who I am?
Well,
if you have seen me, you have seen the Father.
Yeah.
How can you ask me to show you the Father?
Well,
verse 10, don't you believe that I am one with the Father and that the Father is one with me?
I know.
What I say isn't said on my own. The Father who lives in me does these things.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 11, have faith in me when I say that the Father is one with me and that I am one with the Father.
Mm-hmm.
Or else have faith in me simply because of the things I do.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you for certain that if you have faith in me, you will do the same things I am doing.
Yes.
You will do even greater things.
Yes.
Now that I am going back to the Father.
Yes.
Verse 13, ask me and I will do whatever you ask. This way, the Son will bring honor to the Father.
Yes.
I will do whatever you ask me to do. Jesus said to his disciples, if you love me, you will do as I command.
Yes.
Verse 16, then I will ask the Father to send you the Holy Spirit,
woo,
who will help you and always be with you.
Yes.
The Spirit will show you what is true.
Yes.
The people of this world cannot accept the Spirit,
mm-hmm,
because they don't see or know him.
Yes.
But you know the Spirit, who is with you, and I will keep on living in you.
Yeah.
Verse 18, I won't leave you like orphans.
All right.
I will come back to you.
Yes.
And verse 19, in a little while,
the people
of this world won't be able to see me,
well,
but you will see me. And because I live, you will live. Amen.
Amen.
I just read John 14, 1 through 19.
Yeah.
Word of God, the people of God, the Lord of God.
Lord, thank you.
Thank you.
common word. For all that he did, they didn't trust, they didn't believe, they refused. But he took all that.
Up.
They buked it, they beat it,
yes.
They marked it, they
too, because
yeah.
I saw one way, I said, no, but I can't leave this, and da 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 da. If you love me,
all right.
Obey me.
Well,
and I will talk to my Father, and He will give you another comforter. And He will never leave you alone.
Well,
He is the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
The Spirit that leads us into all truth.
Yes.
Yes.
The world at large cannot receive the truth.
Well.
For it is not looking for Him.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't recognize the truth.
Okay.
But you do recognize the truth.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
For He lives with you now. The truth will be with you forever. The world cannot accept the truth, because the world neither sees the truth nor knows the truth. But you know the truth, for the truth lives in you and will be with you and in you. And I will not leave you as orphans. And then it also says, I will come again. I want to talk about the Spirit.
Woo!
Of truth.
Yeah.
And if Reverend Catherine gets you two carried away, somebody come up here and sit on her or something. Hold her down, but she might start jumping over that. You know, he knows what's coming up Friday, and this is Thursday. And he says, I want to create a new covenant, a new bond between you and me. See, Abraham got the first covenant where he says, I'll be your God, you'll be my people. And now Jesus is instituting His covenant.
All right.
And there's a lot going on in the room. Let me try to set this up. You see, the devil was in the room.
Yeah.
The devil is always in the room.
Yeah.
You may not see him, but beware.
Yeah.
He's in the room.
Oh, yeah.
And you know that the devil knew what was on the agenda.
Mm-hmm.
He already knew Jesus thinking about what he was going to do. So he's already planning. He don't want you to come to church today.
Look out now.
Yeah. I wanted to stay comfortable in my air conditioned home. And Deacon Johnson wouldn't let me go. My wife wouldn't let me go. And I said, you know, just cancel church. We'll come back next Sunday. No. The devil is always in the room.
Yes.
He was in that upper room. There was a lot of struggling and going along with Jesus and smiling in his face, but really all they wanted to be was in charge of something or have some power or some money or rule the kingdom. But they had been fussing, the disciples, and fighting among themselves as they walked, it says in John, and Mark doesn't deal with this, but John says that as they walked on the journey road, they were fussing and fighting with one another.
Well,
when they got to the upper room, they got hot tempered, they're mad.
All right.
Well, Jesus can't accomplish what he wants done because the devil done got to him. And so, the scripture says he took off his garment, the upper garment, and got down on his hands and knees.
Yeah.
And washed each of the disciples' feet. You see, he was trying to get them to start thinking about him and stop thinking about them. Bless his heart.
Yeah.
He's always got to be the fool in the bunch.
Oh,
he said to Jesus when he got around him, I don't remember what number one, number one, or number two, you know. But Peter said, I don't want you watching me. No! You can never wash me.
Well.
And Jesus says, well, if I can't wash you, then you need to get behind me.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Because you're obstructing. We've heard the word obstruction a lot. You're obstructing my purpose and what I want to do. And then Peter said, well, Lord, forgive me. Then just wash all of me. All of this was going on in the upper room. The disciples were looking for a payday. They thought this was their day to find out who would be who in the new kingdom. They wanted to find out. And there were mothers that stood outside. Mm-hmm. A couple of them wanted to know, is my son going to be able to sit on the right side or the left side? And Jesus told them, it's not mine to give, it's up to the Father. He will decide.
That's right.
Come on, man.
But as usual, people are always looking for an edge.
Yeah, that's right.
Jesus was trying to teach them to be servants and not rulers. He was trying to emphasize that the function of Christianity is to serve, not to rule.
Yeah.
And this was his purpose. That was one of the things that was on the table. Jesus wanted to teach them and explain to them also the symbolism of the bread and the wine. And he wanted to explain this to them. Okay, you've done the Passover. You done killed all the bulls and cows and birds and everything. All the other animals are running, trying to get away from you because I'm going to have to leave you. This is the other thing that was on the table. They weren't expecting this. You know, they've been with them 3 years. They're looking for payday. They're thinking earth realm. They're thinking what's going on here on the world. Christ was trying to point them to heaven and eternal life. But all they could see was their pockets being full.
All right.
And so Jesus, it's beautiful what it says in the Jim, what you read. Jesus said, I got to leave.
Yeah.
You know, you can't go with me now.
Well.
And what happens? Thomas says, well, wait a minute, Jesus, I'm paraphrasing, but hold up, Lord. How you going to leave us now?
Yeah.
We don't know the way.
No.
You say you get ready to leave us, but that we know the way. We don't know the way.
Yeah.
And then Jesus, very beautifully, a very strong passage of scripture said, I am the way.
Yes.
The truth.
Yes.
And the light.
Yeah.
You see, I don't understand for you how you digest that, but he's the way, which means that's what I should follow.
Yeah.
And then when you tell me he's the truth,
yeah,
then I'm hungry for the truth that will set you free because of all the injuries of life.
Yeah.
And then I look at life. Life without him is not worth living.
Right.
Oh, I don't know. I saw tears in Jim's eyes. I know Ivan feels like that for the way he was preaching.
Yeah.
But the rest of us, how do you feel about him today?
Yeah.
Is he the way, the truth, and the life?
Oh, yeah.
Well, none of us are perfect.
Yeah.
But are you trying to make the life that he offers to you? Am I making any sense?
Yes.
These are on the table. And then Jesus tells them that someone in the room is going to betray him. And the scripture says that all of them shocked. Now they ain't seen this coming. They didn't know what was on the agenda. They didn't see the program.
Well,
and then Jesus says, somebody getting ready to sell me out.
Wow.
And everybody looked at each other. Is it I, Lord? Am I the one? Jesus wanted to talk to them about what was coming.
Yeah.
He knew Friday he was leaving.
Uh-huh.
And Saturday he'd do some things perhaps, but Sunday he's going to be gone.
Yeah.
And he was trying to tell his ignoramuses something. Well, they probably wasn't ignoramuses, but they wasn't baby kids either, so I don't know. But they ain't got a hold of things yet. They don't understand the magnitude like we don't understand the magnitude of what Jesus is trying to offer to us.
Yes. Amen.
We pick and choose what we want.
Amen.
Yeah.
It's all right.
Say it, Pop.
Yes.
Jesus tells them, someone is going to betray me. He didn't say this, but I throw it in for just a little bonus. The kiss will come in the garden. To let the soldiers know who I am.
Yeah.
Then he says, there's so much I want to tell you. And I wish there was some kind of way I could get into that. I wish I could go back 2019 years or whatever it is and let me sit at the table and say, Lord, I don't want to do nothing else until you tell me everything that you want to tell me. I want to know what the future is. I want to know what is ahead. I don't want to travel this road by myself. And if you can help me, Lord, move all my jealousy and my anger and all the other things that are in the way.
Because
you're trying to speak to my spirit.
Amen.
It's all right.
So much I want to tell you.
Yes.
But you're in here full of hell,
and
fussing and fighting about trivial things about a kingdom now here that will never be, that is never going to suffice.
Right.
It will be destroyed. I'm trying to tell you about my Father's kingdom.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So anyway, all this goes on, and he wants to tell them all, but it's too much. It's too much drama going on. You ever been in the room where folks mad? I see y'all shaking your head. You know, I find out, especially when there's a funeral and someone died. Lord have mercy. All the mess that goes on. Fight this, but you want to hit me, baby. All the mess that goes on in that room where folks are fighting over things.
Yes.
Money.
Yeah.
Property.
Yeah.
Can I get amen?
Amen.
They too.
I like what he says finally. He said, I will not leave you as orphans.
Yes.
That means you not having a father or mother.
Yes.
I will leave with you, get this, some help.
Yes.
Jesus says, I'm going to leave you a companion.
Yes.
I'm going to leave with you a comforter.
Yes.
I'm going to leave with you an advocate.
Yes.
I'm going to leave for you a counselor.
Yes.
I'm going to be, somebody is coming who will be an encourager.
Yes.
Someone who will be a protector.
Yes.
Someone who will be a guide. And that name
yes.
of that person is the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit of truth.
Yes.
And that is the third personality of the Trinity. Everybody don't agree with the Trinity. But what is the Trinity? The Father,
yes.
the Son,
yes.
and the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
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 And so the Trinity Woo. Comes. The Holy Spirit will be with you. I like when he says forever.
Yes.
That it will be, it will never leave you.
Yes.
The Spirit of truth lives with you. And in time, it will be in you.
Yeah.
And I hope I got this correct. It says, and I'm making it my own way to describe it. He says, once you accept me,
mm-hmm.
well,
all right.
as Christ, as your Savior,
all right.
Then you will receive my Spirit.
Yes.
There's a cost.
Yes.
There's a price.
Yeah.
There's a requirement.
Yes, Lord.
There is an expectation.
All right.
That God is giving to us. Jesus is saying, this is what you got to do to get my Spirit.
Yeah.
Right?
And the Holy Spirit and the Holy Ghost.
Ooh, Jesus.
Yeah.
We live in a world
my God.
That will never see the truth of Jesus.
Well, yes.
We live in a world where the Holy Spirit of truth
say it.
Cannot be seen
mm-hmm.
by the world.
Yeah.
Because the world does not believe in Jesus.
All right.
And I watch TV and look at the insults that go on about Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah.
The people that laugh and ridicule and lie on Jesus.
Yeah.
Right.
And I said, the world can't get what the Lord has given me.
Yeah.
And the world will never accept Jesus as the way, the truth, and the life. Am I making any sense? I'm trying to help you to understand this is not a physical thing. This is a spiritual thing.
Yes.
And it also tells me, and this is why you need to go, if you don't go to Bible study, you ought to do something with your Bible.
Yeah.
John 8:44 tells you that the devil is the father of lies.
Yeah.
Another translation says, that his language is lie.
Yes.
Lie.
Yeah.
You can't do much with a lie. Yeah. And that's why when folks talk about fake news,
mm-hmm.
and people start talking about alternative facts,
yeah.
that's lie.
Yeah.
The father of lies. Yeah. And that's found in John 8:44.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit will lead you.
Yes, Lord.
I know.
There you go.
I didn't see it coming. I didn't know my wife was standing in the line getting some lunch over at ITC.
All right.
And I saw Olympia. She had on a black shirt and a white block. And she had her hair all pinned back. She was all breezed down and she looked good.
Breezed down.
I jumped in the line. I said, I don't want to be too obvious. But I just want to get where I can just look at it. Well, I didn't know what God was doing there.
All right.
My grandmother told me, she said, where is that gal? And the other girls were in the picture at the time. Well, I wasn't married yet.
Yeah, he wasn't.
And my grandmother said, that's the one you ought to marry.
All right.
And I listened to her and I said, well, I love her, but I'm not ready to settle down. And it came. I'm just showing you how God leads you.
Yeah.
I saw God when he led me through Morehouse.
Mm-hmm.
He put me in ITC.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't doing too well. They put me on probation.
Right.
I was leaving. I was reading at ninth grade level. I mean, I was just awful. But I tell you what, I graduated from ITC with all honors. And encouraged me to get involved with doing something to establish another church. My wife and Brother DeWitt and others, my children, they wanted to do it too, but I didn't see the way. I'm trying to help you to understand how God comes into your life.
Yes, he does.
You didn't know Xavier was out there waiting on you. My son's already crying about Kelly. Talking about how good it is. I want him to come back home, but he ain't coming back. I mean, I'm just looking at each of you and asking you, healthcare wouldn't be a problem.
That's right, that's right.
Because everybody would have healthcare. This is the richest nation in the world. Yeah. We would not miss $1 if we had healthcare.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
What if the Holy Spirit showed us a way to solve the immigration problem?
Yeah, right.
Not separating families.
That's right.
Not putting them in stalls like herds of animals. You know,
right.
It's ridiculous.
Right. Right.
Yeah. But I think that immigration would not. What if the Holy Spirit worked out something where children could go to school and not fear getting shot?
Amen.
Some kind of gun control would come into. I'm just trying to show you what the Holy Spirit could do if it was in the right places.
Yeah.
What is
I'll go with him through the garden.
I'll go with him through the garden.
I'll go with him through.
Victory. I'm so good to see all of you.
Amen.
Especially good to see Ms. Butler back. We do have a few announcements to bear with you. Our church anniversary is supposed to be next Sunday.
Yes, sir.
It has been postponed.
All right.
Due to our unforeseen circumstances.
Yes, sir.
If you have any questions or concerns about that matter, he is the man to see. Pastor is the person to see about that. And also, Ms. Butler, well, Mrs. Butler, floor is yours.
We're working on it. East Point has dug it for the ground, and we're getting ready to dig ours even deeper. Okay, so, you know, the lights outside, it's the pole, it's the portion board. We're waiting on it. I tried to file a claim with Allstate. We can't do anything without the portion board. Right. So that's where we are. The portion board is holding us up. But we're working on it. Mr. Johnson did a marvelous job last week. He went on a Tuesday, went back on a Friday, and we still have not received it. So he and I can go back over tomorrow and hopefully pray for it. We'll come up with something.
Thank you,
Dean
Johnson.
Yes, thank you. We have something tomorrow in our hands and move forward. When I spoke to Allstate, what she said was that if we use our policy, they would fix it, we get back to our festival. However, they will go after the people that at fault, and then they will recover back what is spent.
So we get reimbursed for spending our money?
Yes.
And we won't be charged as for.
We don't have to pay. If we use our policy, we don't have to pay our festival. That's the first thing I asked them. If we use our policy, we're going to pay our deductible, but they will in turn go after the people that caused the accident and get back what we spent, what they spent first, and then our deductible. Okay?
So our deductible is what?
$1,000.
So that's what we're waiting on to see.
Well, we're waiting for the point support because she won't make the move to get the point support. I filed a claim, but without the point support number, they can't do anything. They can't investigate.
I was not out to be out 3 weeks.
Well, thank you for that.
We got a councilman in this area that's supposed to be for the boys as well. Have we tried to reach out to them to get them involved to expedite this? Because it's been 2 weeks now. And not having a police report and all that. All the food got to be gone. Everything.
Yeah.
So it's just not that. It's the principle of us losing the opportunity of people coming.
And we're told that if we get anything, say, starting tomorrow, it would take a minimum of 7 to 10 days to get anything going.
That's all they said.
Well, I have a question.
Yes.
If somebody hits a pole and knocks out my electricity in my house, Georgia Power comes and fix me, so why we even get into our insurance and all of that? Georgia Power comes out and help come?
This is the other issue that Ms. Butler and I talked about this morning. The post was damaged, it was broken, but the wires were still hanging on that post. They had to be disconnected by East Point so they could put in the new post. Am I correct, Ms. Butler?
Well, that's not here. I wasn't here, so I didn't see the pole. And we had pictures to show.
Yeah, we got the
I didn't see the pole.
The cable was snap somewhere.
Okay.
Either the contractor who installed the pole, or, and I think one of the problems I called the officer who wrote the report, he is amending, supposed to have amended the report, even talked with his supervisor. The report should have been ready Friday. When I went back on Friday, a report was not ready.
Any other concerns or questions? So thank you again, Ms. Butler and Johnson, for all of your efforts.
Amen.
Greatly appreciated.
Yes, amen.
Even though it's long, you know, the situation will be resolved.
That's right.
So just stay praying.
That's right.
Let's not also, let's keep Melissa in our prayers as well.
Yeah.
Melissa, you know, is our church member, also a fire member in Alabama. Grandpa passed Friday, so let's keep her and her family in prayer as well. Our church council meeting is on the 23rd of this month, or Sunday. That's when we come together for our calendar events for July through January, and it will be headed by our pastor. So any other concerns, information you want to know about June 23rd, right after church in the back, please see Pastor Bruce one about that. Fourth Sunday is also where we spotlight another business. So if you have someone that you want to spotlight for the great work that they're doing, please let me know. Also, Bible study is every Wednesday night. We'll see about Bible study this week at 6 p.m. We've been talking about it. Reverend Kathy and I have been talking about doing an online Bible study, Facebook Live-ish kind of way. Possibly getting Daddy and Reverend Sharp together in a particular building, having Bible study where you can view it from your comfort of your home while we're trying to get all this fixed. So we're still working on that. We'll be on the lookout for that in Sunday school every Sunday at 9:30. And today is the first Sunday in June. So do we have any June babies here today?
Because of the situation with the electricity, the next Sunday I'm going to cancel the guest speaker, and we still have church, but I think we'll just have a regular worship service, and we can schedule an event later or wait till next year and do it again. But I would like for you to let that be the case, and I'll call Dr. Lynch and she's right here locally anyway, and I'll just tell her events have occurred that we won't be able to, now that I know this, I can get on it today.
Our prayers, Sister Sylvia Dunlap, who laid to rest her aunt, who was a member of this church on Tuesday, Mrs. Marjorie Adams,
who was one of the persons who enabled us to be here. Ms. Adams was 99 years old.
Oh, right.
Yes. So she was like the best.
She put the money on the table.
Yes. Maybe stand in my church. We got in unison.
Heaven led, as we believe, by the Spirit of God, to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior, and on profession of our faith, having been baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we do now in the presence of God, angels in this assembly, most solemnly and joyfully enter into covenant with one another as one body in Christ. We engage therefore, by the aid of the Holy Spirit, to walk together in Christian love, to strive for the advancement of this church in knowledge and holiness, to give it a place in our affections, prayers, and services above every organization of human origin, to sustain its worship, ordinances, discipline, and doctrine, to contribute cheerfully and regularly as God has prospered us towards its expenses for the support of the faithful and evangelical ministry among us, the relief of the poor, and the spread of the gospel throughout the world. In case of difference of opinion in the church, we will strive to avoid a contentious spirit, and if we cannot unanimously agree, we will cheerfully recognize the right of the majority to govern. We also engage to maintain family and secret devotion, to study diligently the Word of God, to religiously educate our children, to seek the salvation of our kindred and acquaintance, to walk circumspectly in the world, to be kind and just to those in our employ, and faithful in the service we promise others, endeavoring in the purity of heart and goodwill towards all men, to exemplify and commend our holy faith. We further engage to watch over, to pray for, to exhort, and stir up each other, and to every good word and work, to guard each other's reputation, not needlessly exposing the infirmities of others, to participate in each other's joys, and with tender sympathy, bear one another's burdens and sorrows, to cultivate Christian courtesy, to be slow to give or take offense, but always ready for reconciliation, being mindful of the rules of the Savior in the 18th chapter of Matthew, to secure without delay, and through life, amid evil report and good report, to seek to live to the glory of God, who has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. When we remove from this place, we engage as soon as possible to unite the Son of the Church, where we can carry out the spirit of the covenant and the principles of God's word.
Thank you.
songs and hymns.